Okay, so in this video today, I'm riding a cross-country bike and I'm gonna do one lap on my clipless pedals I normally ride my cross-country bike on, then again on flat pedals to see the difference in pedaling efficiency. Okay, so the course I'm riding today is pretty mellow. A lot of hard-packed cross-country style trails, but also a couple of pretty punchy climbs where I'm gonna have to put the power down. On my bike, I've got a power meter. I'm wearing a heart rate monitor. So all that information is gonna go to my computer up on the stem. It's gonna tell me how hard I'm working, how much power I'm putting through the pedals, but also lots of detailed information on things like smoothness. So I'll try and ride two really consistent laps with how much effort I'm putting in, and be able to go back to the dirt shed, have a look at the stats and see if there is any difference between flats and clips. Okay, so lap one on the clipless pedals. I've done a quick warm up, done a bit of a sighting lap. So let's see what I can do on clipless pedals. Okay, so lap one done on the clips. Felt good, felt normal. Always ride cross country on clipless pedals now. So time to put the flats on. Doesn't feel right sticking some big pedals like this on a carbon 29er, but let's give it a whirl. Okay, so we're back in the shed to have a look at some results. But first thing I will say is obviously all cross-country pro racers run clipless pedals, so there must be a good reason for that, eh? So let's look at the times. On flat pedals, I did the 6.3 kilometer lap in 18 minutes and 32 seconds. On clips, I did it in 17 minutes 56, so I was faster on clips. However, you're looking at the heart rate results, it does look like I worked that bit harder on clips. So that doesn't really sort of mean that clips were more efficient, I don't think. It just means I probably didn't pace it quite the same. But I think the actual interesting thing is when you come to look at the cadence and the power. So definitely with cadence, I had a slightly higher cadence on clips, but they were much less spiky. So it felt like I kept a much more consistent cadence. Whereas on the flat pedals, it's much more spiky. So I'll put loads of pedal spins in and then I coast for a second and then again. Same with the power curve is much more consistent, so much less spiky. So I think that is the biggest difference really. Yes, it does look like I was working slightly harder because my heart rate was slightly higher on average on the clips, but I definitely, that's what it feels like for me. With the clipless pedals on, I feel like I'm just spinning at a much more consistent rate and I'm not having to just sprint and then coast. So what's the conclusion? I think from this relatively short test, should I say, I definitely think that clipless pedals are slightly more efficient. And for me, it definitely feels that way, especially trying to ride a carbon 29er. They're quite a harsh ride. So on flat pedals, I was bouncing around all over the shop, having to readjust my feet quite a lot. Whereas on the clips, it just felt normal, felt good. Felt like I could spin the pedals really well. Also, after the test, I actually did a max power test, and on the flat pedals, I got quite a weedy 920 watts. On the clips, I got 1173 watts. So a big difference there, 250 watts in max power difference. Okay, so we've done a few of these videos in the past. We've done clips versus flats in the lab, where we really didn't see much difference. And then on a downhill bike, where the flats came out on top. So this is the first time we've actually seen clips take a bit of a lead. I think the next video we need to do is a marathon version of this, so 50K, that's where I think we'll really see the difference. If you want to subscribe to GMBN, click on this logo here, and for clips versus fats in the lab, click up there, and on the downhill bike, down there. Give us a thumbs up if you like this video, and leave some comments down below for the next scientific video you'd like to see.